Hi, welcome back to my channel. I feel like it's been a hot minute. It's been like 2 weeks since I made my channel, put a video up, but I am ready to get back into it. So today's video is going to be on foot pain. I know so many people who suffer from foot pain. I know I do. I know my boyfriend does. I know friends at work who are like, oh, my feet hurt. And I just wanted to make this video giving my tips and tricks on how to help your feet, because I was fortunate enough to work at a foot doctor's office. Technical term would be a podiatrist. That's what medically they're called as doctors. But I worked there for about 7 months and I learned so much about feet, to the point where I feel like I could give some good advice as a friend, you know, help you out as a friend, let you know like about feet and why your feet hurt and what you could do to help your feet. I've been on this journey with my feet for a while now, and I finally, after working there, realized all the things that I need to do, and my feet are in awesome condition. Pain has been all-time low. So yeah, let's get into it. So first I'm going to start off with the anatomy of the foot, because I feel like that's very important for you to understand, because the reason why your foot hurts is because of certain muscles and tendons in your leg that wrap around to your foot that cause the foot pain. So to get technical, I have my medical assisting book here with me with diagrams so I could show you guys. Okay, so I'm going to show you the bones of the foot, just so you can get like a basic idea of where the bones are. So this right here is called the calcaneus, and this is the heel bone. This is the phalanges, this is the metatarsals, and then these up here are the tarsals, and then that right there is your tibia, and then this is your talus bone right here. We're not really gonna like, you know, talk about those because those aren't like super important, but this calcaneus bone is very important because that could lead to a heel spur in the future. If you don't take care of your foot pain now, you could have a heel spur and, you know, have all these other issues. But for right now, these are the basic bones of the foot. So now I'm going to show you the muscles of the foot, because this is like really, this is honestly the most important part, is the muscles. So now the view that I'm going to show you is the posterior view, which is the back. This is the posterior view, and this right here is your Achilles tendon, which is going to be this white thing right here. This white, it wraps around from your calf muscle down and around your foot, creating the plantar fascia, which is the very bottom of your foot. So this Achilles tendon is super important because this is what allows the foot to bend and allow the foot to stretch and to, it's basically what holds the muscles together between that calf muscle and your foot. Super important. That's why people who have Achilles tendon injuries, it takes them forever to heal, and most of the time they end up not being able to bend their foot a certain way or possibly even walk again, because the Achilles tendon, once it's damaged, it's done. Like, there's nothing you could do to repair that. So the gastrocnemius is this calf muscle right here that connects to the Achilles tendon right here. So the gastrocnemius is essentially your calf muscle. Super important as well, because if that's tight, that's going to create a tight Achilles tendon, a tight plantar fascia, and basically that's going to make your foot hurt. Like, you're going to have some serious foot pain if that muscle is tight and you can't flex it. And then I'll show you another diagram of the side view so you can kind of under, this one is a little bit better of a view. So this one right here, this guy, he is bending his foot, as you can see, and that's a negative zero because that means I got nothing wrong because I'm smart. No, I'm just kidding. But anyways, so this is my book from school. So it has all like my class assignments and stuff in it. So I'm sorry. But anyway, so here is the gastrocnemius. So you can see it's his calf muscle right here. So that stretches down into the Achilles tendon, and the Achilles tendon wraps around the back of the foot, creating the plantar fascia. The plantar fascia is basically right here, down here in the middle. And then that would be the heel bone and the toes and all that. So yeah, that is the basic anatomy of the foot. So that is like all the stuff that you would need to know about your foot, and how once you identify those problems, like where your pain is, you can treat them accordingly. So plantar fasciitis is basically a big fancy word for inflammation of the plantar fascia. That's all it means. Inflammation of the plantar fascia. Basically, in normal people terms, that means that your plantar fascia is basically irritated, and it is, you know, constricted and tight, and it cannot flex. Like it should be able to flex. And what's happening is it's probably like either super, super, super tight like this. If your calf muscle is tight, your plantar fascia will be tight, causing your foot to just be in constant pain when you're walking on it. So the number one tip that I have for you, which if you walk into any podiatrist office, this is what they're going to tell you. And I know this because I was a medical assistant for a podiatrist. So here are my tips. Number one, stretching, 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 stretching. Like this is so important. If you walk into a podiatrist office, that's the first thing they're going to tell you. Oh, you need to do stretches. And you're going to be there sitting there like, wow, I came to the doctor for him to tell me to do stretches. Really? Like, wow. Yeah, it's like that simple. I'm telling you, it's so simple. Stretch your calves. If you want, what you could do is lean up against the wall. You're going to put your hands up against the wall. So, and then you're going to extend your leg out and you're going to stretch your calf. I know that some people out there may have a gym membership. If you go to the gym and they have like a little stretching machine, which has like a bunch of bars on it, you could stretch your calves on there. You can also stretch your calves laying on the floor. You can get a sock and like wrap it around your foot and pull. You're just going to pull your foot. Basically, you want your leg. I'll give you an example. So if you're laying down, like here's your foot. If you're laying down, you want your foot to be able to bend backwards. Like let's pretend this is your calf right here. You want this to bend back, because stretching this plantar fascia and Achilles tendon out is going to help you so much. Like just bend your foot back. You need to do these stretches at least 3 to 4 times a day. So once in the morning when you wake up, once like midday, once in the afternoon, once at night, like 4 times a day. That's how many times you're supposed to do it. If you can only do it 3, then I guess you could do 3 and that would be okay. But you're supposed to do it 4 times a day. You're supposed to keep your calf muscle as loose as possible, allowing those muscles to stretch, because if they're really tight, that is what causes your foot pain. Tip number 2, which is also super easy. You could do this at home. This is like nothing that you're gonna have to go and pay to do. Get ice water. So what you're gonna do is freeze this. Obviously, this is just what I had behind me, but what you're gonna do is get a bottle of water full, and you're gonna freeze it, and it's gonna turn into, you know, the hard ice bottle of water, and you're gonna roll your foot on top of it. You're gonna roll it underneath your foot, and it feels so good. Oh my gosh. It just like basically allows those muscles to get some ice on it, rolls it out, makes it not hurt so much. Just the rolling motion in general feels really good. You can also use tennis balls. I've had a patient told me that he uses tennis balls and those feel really good too. But this is like if your feet are hurting really bad and they're hot and they're irritated, this would really help. Which I'm sorry I don't have an example. I mean, I wasn't planning on filming this video today. It kind of just happened. So sorry I didn't have an example to show you, but you get it, right? So tip number 3, good shoes. This is like so important. It doesn't matter how much you stretch. It doesn't matter how much ice you use. If you're not wearing good shoes, then you could just forget it, because basically you're trying to do these stretches, you're doing these things to try and help your feet, but then you go and put your feet and walk around in crappy shoes all day, you're really not helping yourself. You're just kind of counteracting what you're doing to help yourself. You're making it worse in the end. So I'm gonna give you some examples of shoes that you should not wear. Now, Converse. I love these shoes when I was in high school. Actually, these are from high school. I love these shoes. I used to tell they're a little dirty. I used to wear them all the time. They have no arch in them. These are flat. These have no support. If you're wearing these and you're wondering why your feet hurt, that's because they don't have an arch. Like, it's flat in here. It goes completely flat. There's no way for your foot to get supported. All right. And I'll show you an example of a sandal with no arch support. Now, these sandals, super cute. I love them. I used to wear them all the time. I thought that they were adorable. They're very fashionable. No arch. Can you see how flat they are? I used to wonder all the time, why do my feet hurt so bad after wearing these? Maybe because they're flat? Because they don't have an arch? I don't know. I didn't know this stuff, people. I didn't know. Okay, so I'm gonna get into wearing like gym shoes or athletic shoes. So who is a fan of Nike? I am. I used to be, not anymore. These are Nikes. Okay, obviously we all know what Nike is. We all have them. Now, I used to think that Nikes were the best, that these are the best shoes, like no one could beat Nikes, but these are the worst shoes you could buy. Now, there might be some good Nikes out there with some really good support. There might be, but they're probably like, you know, really expensive. These, I think, were like 60 or 70 bucks. And they were pretty cheap. But they have no support in them. They are completely flat. Like, no support. Flat in here. Like, nothing. And look at how fast they break down. Like, on the sides, you see all these ripples? They just break down so fast. You see that? They're done. Like, they have no support. These are basically hurting my feet more than helping my feet. Now, if you're thinking, well, Nike, that's all I wear. Like, what am I going to wear next? Now, look at this. My doctor recommends New Balance, which you can see New Balance on the back. Now, you could tell, like, look at the quality in these shoes are so different. I mean, it's really holding together. Now, the ends, yes, they do have a little crease right here, but the crease is actually from this right here. It's not from me wearing it. So good quality shoes. Now, these are around the same price as those Nikes that I paid for, but yet they have an arch in them. These are good quality. They're not going to break down as fast as those Nikes. So you kind of have to be aware of like what you're buying. New Balance and ASIC gels are what the doctor recommends. These are good shoes compared to Nike. So these are, you know, gonna last you a little longer, gonna be better for your feet. These are also wide. I got a wide version because I'll get into it in a second, but I have orthotics that actually go inside of here, and this is wider around the toe box, so you have more room to just your feet to be comfortable. Okay, and last but not least, I just purchased some Birkenstocks, and I'm actually wearing them right now. These are so freaking expensive, like so expensive, but they are so necessary because these have an arch in them. These are supporting your feet. They actually are made of cork and they mold to your foot. As you can see, I have an imprint of my toes in there. I just bought these last week and I have been breaking them in every day. These are highly recommended by any podiatrist that you go to. They'll tell you, you need to get Birkenstocks. Yes, they're ugly. Yes, they're not like super fashionable. I mean, I got like pretty ugly ones like these. I like leather and I like brown, so this is why I bought these, because they kind of match with everything. But they do have cute versions of these Birkenstocks. They have cute ones. I mean, I'll link the website down below where you can go and check them out. But super pricey, but because they are molding to your feet, they are super, super important for anyone who has flat feet or who has plantar fasciitis, because it has an arch in it and it's gonna hold up your arch and it's going to give you support. So these are, I finally had to invest and get these. I mean, for the longest time I was like, how much are they? What? Like, I'm not buying those. But I gave in and I bought them only because I couldn't be wearing like flip-flops like these anymore. I mean, I know these aren't flip-flops, but I couldn't be wearing something like this. Is not going to help my feet. Something like this is. And I mean, you could just tell, like, can you tell there's an arch in there? Can you see it? I don't know if you can, but look at the difference. Flat, arch. I don't even have anything else to say after that. So my very last tip for you guys is orthotics. Now, these you might have to go to the doctor to get, because these are custom. So I molded my feet into foam, sent them to a lab, and then they send these to you and you put them inside of your shoes. These are basically what hold up your arch. It's formed to your foot and give you maximum support. So these are like a lifesaver for me. I needed these, and you can put these in any shoe. Here's my New Balance shoe that I have, and here's the orthotic. Here's the back of it, and you slide it in, and it just goes right in there, and you put your foot in, and then you just walk like normal, and it gives you the best support. Like, these are a lifesaver. I can't even tell you. Ever since I got these, my feet have been so much better. You might have to go to a doctor to get these. They're not going to be easily accessible. You might be able to buy them on Amazon. They're not going to be custom to your feet though. They're going to be called prefabricated orthotics. So they're going to be already pre-made, and then you kind of have to like guess. But honestly, I think you might be able to buy these like at a specialty foot store, like someplace where they sell like special shoes for like diabetics and stuff. They might have these there. You might have to do some research and find it, but these are so, so, so great and so expensive. Most of the time, insurances do not pay for these. Unless you have some really good insurance and they pay for them, you might have to pay cash. I know I had to pay cash even though I worked at that doctor's office. I did have to pay for these. I got an employee discount because I worked there, but these are so important. That's why these are my last tip, because this is like a last resort. If none of the things that you're doing are helping you, you might want to consider going to a doctor and talking about these with the doctor, because these are going to help you. They're totally, totally worth every penny. If your pain's not getting any better, it might be necessary to get these. I know that this is very vague and very, you know, not super detailed, but hopefully you get a good understanding of what could be wrong with your feet, what you can do to help your feet before you go to the doctor's office and drop some money down for all these things that I'm basically telling you for free, that you can help yourself at home without needing to go to the doctor. Now, I do think you need to go to a doctor if you're having extreme foot pain in your heel. That could mean that you have a heel spur, and a heel spur you might need to get a cortisone injection in your heel spur, which you'll definitely have to go to the doctor to get. And you'll know if you have a heel spur if you're walking and you can't put your heel down on the floor without it being sharp pain, like excruciating sharp pain. And then that way you'll know, like, oh, I have a heel spur, or maybe I might have a heel spur. At that point, you need to go to the doctor, get checked out, see what they say. They're probably going to tell you to do stretching. They're probably going to tell you to do the ice, get good shoes, and maybe give you a cortisone injection to alleviate that pain in the heel. All right, so that wraps up my video. So 4 tips: stretching, ice, good shoes with support in them, and orthotics as a last resort if none of those 3 things are helping you. Other than that, I hope you guys try my tricks at home. I hope it helps you. If you guys have any questions, comment down below. I can try and help you out the best that I can. I'm not an expert. I've only worked at that podiatry office for 7 months, but in that time I learned so much. So hopefully save you some money before you go to the doctor and, you know, you rack up a bill. I'm really excited to start getting some videos up and, you know, getting my content out there. So yeah, see you on the next one. Bye.